Hello everyone, welcome you all in the video lecture series related to heat and mass transfer. Today we are going to start new chapter named as heat exchangers. University has provided the following syllabus under this particular chapter. That is nothing but classification and types of heat exchanger, fouling factor, overall heat transfer coefficient, analysis by LMTD and NTU method, design consideration for heat exchanger and heat pipe. Today in this particular lecture we are going to cover the first point, that is nothing but classification and types of heat exchangers. First of all, we need to understand the meaning of chapter name, that is nothing but heat exchanger. So what is meant by heat? It is the energy in transient state possessed by means of temperature difference. And what is meant by exchangers? The device which transfer heat from one location to another location, that is nothing but heat exchanger. So for the sake of interest, I would like to give some example. First one is nothing but our body. So our body continuously maintaining the temperature near about 36 degrees Celsius. So for that purpose, body continuously exchanging the heat with the surrounding. So this is one kind of example related to our body. Another example, if you take the refrigeration consists of two type of a heat exchanger. First one is nothing but condenser, second one is nothing but evaporator. In the condenser, the latent heat of vapor transferred to the surrounding and the vapor get condensed, whereas in evaporator the latent heat of evaporation taken from the compartment and the liquid will get converted into vapor. So this is the simple example of our refrigeration. Then take the example of milk dairies, big milk dairies, where for the heating of a milk the large size heat exchangers are used. Now the question in your mind, that why not the milk heated by using the burner and the pot? Daily life we are doing the same thing for heating the milk, we are using the burner and the pot. But the most important thing is nothing but efficiency for heating the milk, and second thing is nothing but time required for heating the milk. Okay, so if you want to reduce the time of a process, that is nothing but heating the any material or any liquid, and if you want to reduce the cost of that particular process, then we need to use the heat exchanger. So these heat exchangers are nothing but equipments which transfer the energy from a hot fluid to a cold fluid with maximum rate within a short span of time and minimum investment and minimum running cost. So that is nothing but heat exchangers. According to the application, we need to select the proper heat exchanger. So for that purpose, we should know which are the types of heat exchanger available, or which kind of heat exchanger we can design. So we need to understand the classification of a heat exchanger. The heat exchangers are classified on the basis of, the first one is nature of heat exchanger process, second one is relative direction of fluid motion, then third one is design and construction features, and fourth one is a physical state of fluid. According to the nature of heat exchanger process, there are two types of a heat exchanger. One is direct contact or open type, and second one is indirect contact type of a heat exchangers. First one, that is nothing but direct contact or open type of heat exchanger. So according to nature of heat exchanger process, the first classification is direct contact or open type. So in such a heat exchanger, exchange of a heat takes place by direct mixing of hot and cold fluid and transfer of heat as well as mass takes place simultaneously. Consider this particular figure. In this particular, this is a direct contact type of a heat exchanger or open type of heat exchanger. So from one side, the cold water entered in this particular section, and from another time, from another side, steam get entered in this particular section. Now, this particular steam will lose its latent heat to this particular water, and it will get condensed. So that we will get the hot water from one side, and from another side we will get the non-condensable gases. So the cold water get heated by direct mixing of a steam into it. So this is the direct type or a open type of a heat exchanger. Second classification of heat exchanger on the basis of nature of heat exchanger process is nothing but indirect contact type of heat exchanger. Now this indirect contact type of heat exchangers further classified as recuperators and regenerators. In indirect contact type of heat exchanger, the first one is a recuperator. So it is the most important type of heat exchanger in which flowing fluid exchanging heat are on another side of dividing wall. So this type of heat exchanger used when the two fluids are not allowed to mix each other. Okay, so there is one dividing wall provided in between the hot fluid and cold fluid, so that we can say that the hot fluid first of all transfer the heat to the wall, and then wall will transfer the heat to the cold fluid. So this is the most important type of a heat exchanger. Then another type of indirect contact type of heat exchanger is regenerator, where we have to understand this particular diagram. Okay, so this is one kind of a rotating drum, where this drum inside part is consist of a special matrix whose heat capacity or thermal capacity is very high. So from one side we are transforming the hot fluid over that particular matrix, so that particular matrix will capture the heat from the fluid and it rotate to another side, whereas from the another side the cold fluid will be transferred over that particular matrix, and the matrix will transfer the heat to that particular cold fluid. So the heat capturing will happen in a hotter section, and heat release will happen in a colder section. So it is called as a regenerator type of a heat exchanger. Now second classification of heat exchanger can be done on the basis of relative direction of a motion. The classification will be in this manner: parallel flow or unidirectional flow, second one is a counter flow, third one is a cross flow. Then what is meant by parallel flow? In parallel flow, you have to understand this particular diagram or consider this diagram for the parallel flow. So from one end So here we need to understand this particular diagram for the parallel flow. In case of a parallel flow, both the fluids are entered in a same direction only and leaving in another direction. So we can say that this red line showing the hot fluid and this black line showing the cold fluid. Both the fluids are entered in the same direction only. Okay, and they are leaving on another side. So here we need to understand this particular temperature variation diagram for the parallel flow. So we have to put, so the x-axis shows the length of the heat exchanger, and y-axis shows the variation of temperature. So initially at the entry of that particular heat exchanger, so the cold fluid enters with the temperature TC1, whereas the hot fluid enters with the temperature TH1. Okay, so as this fluid moves inside this particular heat exchanger, the cold fluid temperature goes on increasing, whereas the hot fluid temperature goes on decreasing. So initial temperature difference is nothing but TH1 minus TC1, whereas the final temperature difference is TH2 minus TC2. Then the second type of heat exchanger on the basis of relative direction of motion is nothing but counterflow. So in case of a counterflow, the fluids are moving opposite to each other. Now here we have to consider that. So hot fluid entered in this direction, whereas the cold fluid enters in an opposite direction. So motion of this particular two fluids will be in an opposite, whereas the hot fluid comes out of heat exchanger from this direction, whereas the cold fluid comes out of the heat exchanger in this direction. So we have to draw the temperature variation diagram according to the length of that particular heat exchanger. So here we can say that on this side the hot fluid entered, that is nothing but TH1 temperature will be provided on this side for the zero length of heat exchanger, and the cold fluid entered from another side, where the heat exchanger length over at that point, the cold fluid entered in the heat exchanger and it will lose through another side, whereas the hot fluid entry is there, and the hot fluid come out of the heat exchanger where the cold fluid entry is there. Okay, so as the length, we have to consider that the hot fluid temperature goes on decreasing as the length of heat exchanger goes on increasing, whereas the cold fluid temperature goes on decreasing as the length of heat exchanger goes on increasing. So in this case, the initial temperature difference we have to consider as a theta 1 as a TH1 minus TC2, whereas the final temperature difference we have to consider as theta 2 is equal to TH2 minus TC1. The third classification is cross flow type of heat exchanger. Now here both the fluids are not mixing with each other. We are considering that the hot fluid is moving through the pipe and the cold fluid is moving above that particular pipes. Okay, so here we have provided the two classification. When the cold fluid allowed to mix over the surface or the exchanging surface, and another one is the cold fluids are unmixed, does not allow to mix over the heating surface. So for that purpose, the two streams of cold fluids are separated over here. Okay, and these are crossing in a right angle. Here also they are flowing in a right angle. So the two fluids are flowing in a right angle. For that purpose, it is called as a cross flow type of a heat exchanger. Then further classification of heat exchanger is on the basis of design and construction feature. So according to design and construction feature, the heat exchangers are classified as concentric tubes, shell and tubes, multiple shell and tube passes, and compact heat exchanger. The first classification, that is nothing but concentric tube. Here, what is meant by concentric tube? Here we need to understand that the one small tube is placed concentrically in a big tube. Okay, so the one tube having the smaller diameter and one tube is having the bigger diameter. So one fluid is flowing through the bigger diameter tube, whereas the another fluid is flowing through smaller diameter tube. So here the representation is for double pipe heat exchanger parallel flow arrangement. Okay, so we can say that when the two fluids are entering from the same direction and leaving from another direction, then we can say that the flow of the fluid is parallel flow. Okay, so and the second one is double pipe heat exchanger for the counter flow. So here we can say that the two fluids are flowing opposite to each other. Okay, so from one side one fluid is entering inside the heat exchanger, and from that side only the another fluid is leaving the heat exchanger, whereas from the another side the one fluid is coming out of the heat exchanger, whereas the another fluid entering in the heat exchanger. So this arrangement is for the counterflow arrangement. So if here we need to understand what is meant by concentric tube. So tube in tube heat exchangers, we called it as a tube in tube heat exchanger also, because the small tube is placed in a big tube concentrically. So that tube in tube heat exchangers are also called as a concentric tube heat exchangers. Second classification according to the construction is nothing but shell and tube heat exchanger. So here we need to understand what is meant by shell and what is meant by tubes. So shell is nothing but bigger size compartment. This orange colored compartment we can see, it is called as a shell. It is a bigger size compartment, and that particular compartment number of tubes are provided. So one fluid, we can say that one fluid is called as a shell fluid and another fluid is called as a tube fluid. Okay, so here we can say that the one fluid, hot fluid, is entering from this side and it is entering inside the tube. So hot fluid is flowing through the tube, whereas the cold fluid is entering from this side, okay, and it is flowing through the shell or through the compartment. So for that purpose it is called as a shell fluid. Okay, now here we have to see, we can see these kinds of baffles, these kinds of construction over here. Okay, vertical lines, you can see it is called as a baffle plate. Okay, so baffles plays very much important role in case of a shell and tube heat exchanger. Because why? If baffles will not be there, the fluid, shell fluid, entered from this side and it will directly goes to the outlet port. Okay, so to create the distribution in that particular compartment, or to create the turbulence in a fluid, this baffles plays very much important role. So the fluid will enter from this side, it will comes in the contact with that particular tubes, and it will take the maximum heat from the tube. Once again it will go in this direction, whereas once again it will comes in the contact with the tube and it will move in this direction. So baffles will create the turbulence in the fluid, as well as it will provide the maximum area for the heat exchanger in a shell and tube type of heat exchanger. Now here the particular example is one shell pass and two tube pass heat exchanger. So one shell is nothing but there is only one compartment, so for that purpose it is called as a one shell heat exchanger. And the two tubes, here you can see that there are four tubes, and you are saying that there are the two tubes only passes. Now here we have to concentrate that if the fluid is entering in this particular tube, okay, and it is flowing through that tube and it is leaving this tube at that particular location. Now once it leave, it will enter out of this two fluid, out of this two tube. Okay, so one fluid will passes in a two tubes. Okay, so from these two tubes the fluid will move in this direction, and from these two tubes the fluid will move in this direction. Okay, so there are two passes for the fluid. Okay, so it is on the basis of passes of a fluid, how many times the fluid passes in that particular compartment or through that particular channel. So here we can say that the fluid will passes two times, one is in this direction and another one is in this direction. So there are two tube passes for a fluid. So for that particular purpose it is called as a one shell pass and two tube pass heat exchanger. Now the third classification on the basis of construction is multiple shell and tube passes. Okay, multiple shells means what? Instead of one compartment there are multiple compartments. So here you can see that in this particular diagram there are two compartments provided for the fluid passes, for the shell fluid passes there are two compartments. Now the another fluid entered in this particular direction. Okay, so here there are two passes for the fluid. Okay, and then it will enter in another shell. Here there are two passes for the fluid. So actually the four passes for the fluid, and there are two compartments for the shell fluid pass, for the shell fluid. So we can say it as a two shell pass and four tube pass heat exchanger.
Next classification of heat exchanger is on the basis of physical state of fluid. On that basis, the heat exchangers are classified as condenser and evaporators. So here we can see the two diagrams, one is for the condenser and another one is for the evaporator. So in case of a condenser, this straight line shows the temperature of working fluid. Okay, so in a condenser, the vapor loses its latent heat to the another fluid, and it will convert from vapor to liquid state. Okay, so latent heat only released by this particular vapor in condenser, so its temperature will remain same, whereas the cold fluid temperature goes on increasing as with respect to length of heat exchanger. Now in case of a evaporator, the temperature of working fluid once again constant, which is very low, and the temperature of the surrounding fluid will decrease, and the latent heat will be captured by the working fluid. Okay, only latent heat will capture by the working fluid, so that its temperature will remain same and its phase will change from liquid to vapor. Okay, so here we are considering that both the heat exchangers are a parallel flow heat exchanger, so that the fluids are moving in a same direction only. And the initial temperature difference, we can say that TH1 minus TC1, whereas the final temperature difference is TH2 minus TC2 in both the cases. Now the another type of heat exchanger, or we can say that the classification, is compact heat exchangers, whereas we are going to see two types of a compact heat exchanger. First one is a heat pipe, second one is a plate type heat exchanger. So heat type, heat pipe, it is a special type of heat exchanger used in electronics devices such as computers, laptops, because of its extraordinary feature to reduce the heat from the heating area. Okay, so why it is called as a special type of heat exchanger? Because in this particular heat pipe, there are two sections. One is the evaporative section. This is the evaporative section, and another one is the condenser section. In evaporative section, the heat will be taken from the heated section or heated device, and whereas in the cool condenser section, heat will be transferred to the surrounding. Obviously, the special type of a material used to perform this action. So the weak type of structure will be used for the performance of this particular heat pipe. So this section is weaker section, we called it as weaker section. Now once and when fluid is continuously flowing in this particular heat pipe, okay, the special type or nano fluids are used to transfer the energy, whose the evaporation temperature is very low. Such fluids are used to perform the working of that particular heat pipe. Now in this particular heating section, the heat will be taken by this particular fluid and it will get evaporated. Now these vapors will flow under the gravity acceleration towards the condensation section. Now here heat will be transferred to the surrounding, and once again this particular vapor will get condensed and convert into liquid, and this will be captured by this weaker section, and due to the capillary action, it will travel once again into a evaporative section. So for that purpose, it is called as a special type of heat exchanger, because it consists of a two heat exchanger, that is nothing but evaporative section and condenser section. Another type of compact heat exchanger is nothing but plate type of heat exchanger. So specifically it is called as a plate type because number of plates are used to exchange the heat between hot fluid and cold fluid. Now here we can see that the direction of flow. Now in this direction the hot fluid is flowing, whereas the another direction the cold fluid is flowing. So it is a counter flow type of heat exchanger. Now from one side you can see here the for one plate the cold fluid is transferred to that particular plate over that particular plate, whereas from another plate the cold fluid is transforming in a opposite direction. Okay, so here the turbulence will be created on the each and every plate by augmentation technique, by creating crust and troughs and the flow varying the flow direction, so that the heat transfer rate in this particular plate type of heat exchanger is very high and the area required for this particular heat exchanger is very less. So for that purpose it is called as a compact type of heat exchanger. Thank you.